greetings. Brother Ahmed, thank you for the long post containing so many of Islam's erroneous claims. While I have individual videos addressing nearly all of these already, you have given me a great opportunity to summarize for your benefit. You know for a fact that Mohammed was prophesied in the Gospel of John. Translating comforter, Jesus had predicted the coming of a human prophet spirit after him, and not the Holy Spirit. First, we do not know this for a fact. Second, the Quran claims Jesus brought the Injil, and Islam claims that the Injil no longer exists. And that begs a question, brother. When Islam must produce evidence to support Muhammad's claim of Sura 7, 157 and 158, why does it try to use the Gospel of John? Muhammad said that he was mentioned in the Injil, the Gospel of Jesus, not the Gospel of John. Islam thus admits unknowingly that the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, are the Injil. Think about it, brother. Translating comforter, Jesus had predicted the coming of a human prophet, spirit, after him, and not the Holy Spirit. To truly understand what Jesus said, brother, you must be willing to read all that Jesus said. If you will honor and respect Prophet Jesus enough to read all his words, you create an opportunity to receive from God. John 14:15, if you love me, and this is Jesus speaking, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you, meaning live with you, forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it sees him not, neither knows him, but you know him, for he dwells with you and shall be in you. Now, brother, in that one passage, which is only one of several, Jesus already answers your confusion. Islam's error-filled argument is, the Comforter cannot be the Holy Ghost, because the Holy Ghost, according to the Bible, was with them already, and even quite active long before the coming of Jesus. The core of Islam's error is the phrase, was with them already. The Holy Ghost was with them already. But recall what Jesus said of the Comforter. In John 14:16, and he shall give you another Comforter. Continuing in verse 17, but you know him, you know this Comforter, you already know this Comforter, for he dwells with you, for he, this Comforter, dwells with you. Please try to understand what Jesus said, brother. The disciples already knew the Comforter, but you know him, for he dwells with you. Please allow me to explain the nature of the confusion in Islam's thinking, brother. Islam's argument is the following logic path. Jesus will send the Comforter. Sending implies the Comforter is not already there, right? If the Comforter is not already there, anyone already there cannot be the Comforter. The Holy Spirit was already there, and therefore cannot be the Comforter. Now let me talk you through the error, brother. Sending implies the Comforter is not already there. While that is a possible implication, it is only one of several. Let me give you an example. I can send my son to the store to buy something. I can send my son to the store to get a job. If I send him to buy something, I send him as a customer. If I send him to get a job, I send him as an employee. There is a difference in status and relationship. In the Old Covenant, the Holy Spirit would come on the prophets on the outside like a cloak or garment. Numbers 24:2. And Balaam lifted up his eyes and saw Israel camping tribe by tribe, and the Spirit of God came upon him. He took up his discourse and said, "The oracle of Balaam, the son of Beor, and the oracle of the man whose eye is opened." Prophet Balaam spoke after the Holy Spirit came upon him. And Jesus confirmed that the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, was already with the disciples. The word "was" implies a past or present time, brother. We know the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, was with the disciples. "But you know him, for he dwells with you." That's what Jesus said. That is the current state when Jesus was speaking. And then Jesus continues with these words, "and shall be." The words "shall be" speak of the future. When in the future? "After I send the Comforter to you." Then what? "And shall be in you." When Jesus sends the Comforter with them will then live in them. This is a huge change in status and relationship, brother. That is why Islam's logic is simply wrong on the whole topic. Sending implies the Comforter is not already there. This assumed implication is a flawed assumption. The Comforter was already there. This is what Prophet Jesus, who revealed the Comforter, said of the Comforter. And what Jesus said has other implications, brother. Consider the following logic that is actually based on what Jesus said. Jesus will send the Comforter. Jesus said the disciples already knew the Comforter, who was already there. If the Comforter is already there, it cannot be someone coming later. The Comforter, therefore, cannot be Mohammed, who came 600 years later. This irrefutably proves that Mohammed cannot be the Comforter. Or if you prefer, brother, another irrefutable proof, consider the following. Jesus promised the Comforter to the disciples. Jesus said the disciples already knew the Comforter, who was already there. If the Comforter did not come to the disciples, then Jesus lied to the disciples. If Mohammed was the Comforter 600 years later, Jesus lied to the disciples. Islam's jihad that Mohammed is the Comforter requires Jesus to be a liar. So, brother, it is logically and historically impossible that Mohammed was the Comforter of John chapters 14, 15, and 16. Again, Islam's argument is the Comforter cannot be the Holy Ghost because the Holy Ghost was with them already. This is clearly proven to be an error, brother, based on ignoring what Jesus actually said. I pray that God would allow you to hear what Jesus said, brother, and listen to it with ears that respect God. I'll continue to answer your other points in coming videos, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.